Wouldn't it be nice if every time you pushed save in Microsoft Word, a version of your document was benchmarked so that you could go back and refer your document back to any point in time that you wanted? This is one of the most important advantages that Git gives you, the ability to make, save, and restore points so that you can restore your file back to any time in history if it ends up breaking or if you accidentally delete something. In this section, we will be talking about the basics of committing files in Git. This will be best done by showing you an example. Right now, I have cloned my project from GitHub, as shown in the last tutorial. Currently, the repository is pretty empty. I'm going to create a project in NetBeans and store the project in the directory of my repository. Once I do, Git notices that something has changed within our directory and notifies me of the different file changes. In this case, each file is new and did not exist before, which is indicated by this blue question mark. Git is telling us, I have never seen this file before. Would you like to add this file to your repository and begin tracking changes of it? Until you add this file to the repository, it will not begin tracking changes on it. So we want to add it as soon as possible to the repository to take advantage of Git's ability to track changes and make restore points. Notice at the bottom of SourceTree that there are two areas, the staging area and the unstaging area. We'll be working in this section to commit changes. The steps to add a file to the repository are 1. Select the files in the unstaged file list. 2. Drag them to the restored files area. The staged area is similar to a print preview. It is showing you the changes that you are about to commit to the repository. 3. Click on the commit button. 4. You will notice that on the right is a line by line preview of the files you are adding. At the bottom is a space for you to put in comments about your update. You should, and are sometimes required, to add a comment for every commit that you should make. This is good practice that you should give a brief description of the change that you are making. 5. Click on the commit button on the bottom right. What you have just done is to take a snapshot of your code at this moment, and a preview of the changes of that snapshot are shown to you in your Tree Explorer. You will notice that your name is attached to that commit, as well as the comment and the unique SHA-1 value for that commit, but that's not too important right now. You can add more files by doing the same process. It is not required that you commit all the changes available to you in the unstaged file list. Only select the files and changes that you wish to commit. At this point, if you are seeing many more files than my list is showing in the unstaged files, it is because your Git ignore was set up differently than mine. That is fine. We will cover how to customize that later. So now, let's say that we want to make some changes to our Java class and have reached a logical save point and we wish to commit this snapshot. First of all, you will notice that Git has noticed that you have changed your file. Unlike the blue question mark, it now shows yellow dots. This is because your file has been added to the repository and Git is now tracking changes made to that file. You will notice that if you click on the file name in the unstaged files list, you will see a preview of the difference between what you have done and what was last committed. Red lines indicate lines of code that have been deleted, and green lines indicate lines of code that are being added. Git tracks a file line by line, so you will only see the individual lines that have been changed. This is a big advantage to you as a programmer. I can see in this preview that I made a mistake in my file, and I don't want to save that in this commit. I can go back to that file in NetBeans, edit it, and remove those lines of code. But to make these things simple, SourceTree allows you to select the lines that I don't like and click on Discard Lines. Discard Lines does not mean it is going to get rid of those lines forever, but rather to get rid of the changes that are occurring to those specific lines. In this case, since I was adding these lines, Discard Lines will simply remove the change to add them, which deletes them from my file. You will see now that if I go back to my file, those lines are now gone. So be careful about doing this because you cannot get back changes that weren't committed to the repository. Now that I have the code at a better save point, I'm going to do a similar process as we did to add the files to the directory. I will click on Commit, drag the changes I want to the staged files area. I will add a commit message and then click on commit. Notice that there is a new commit added to your Tree Explorer and that those changes are no longer showing up in the unstaged file section. That is because the unstaged files section only shows differences between your current files and what was last committed. And at this point, we haven't changed the files at all since we last committed. The moment that we change one of these files, it will show that change in the unstaged files list. And we can do similar things to discard or commit those changes. If we don't like what we have done with the entire file since we last committed, we can simply right-click the file in the unstaged files and click on discard, which doesn't mean that it will delete the entire file, but rather it will discard all changes made to that file since the last commit. Let's say that you want to delete the file. If you delete the file from your computer, it is not actually gone from the Git repository. We can stage this change and commit it just as we would any change to the file. If we do so, you will notice that a new commit is added to the repository. However, remember that once a file has been added to the repository at any point in time, it is possible to recover that file by simply undoing this commit of deleting the file. This will be explained to you in a future tutorial, but you should feel safe in knowing that if the file you deleted was a mistake, you can always return the file again, thanks to Git. As I click on the different commits in the tree explorers, we can see how Git functions. It tracks all these changes and simply makes a snapshot of the change at each commit. We can see what my username has done, the attached message explaining my work, and a preview of each change.